Stencils are among the most versatile supplies in crafting. All the techniques that you can do, from simple to luscious layers and more advanced. Today is going to be super simple, so let's get to it. I'm going to work on a page of my Joggles Discbound journal, and I'm using a new tool I came across in one of Ardit's video, and I have been experimenting with the blender brushes, and though they work great, they are quite big, so the smaller size is actually very nice. Then I'm going to add my stencil in place. I'm going to start with the first layer, and then I start with applying the ink on the complete background with the first color. And I'm using Distress Oxide ink for this, but you can use any ink for this technique. I'm applying the ink in a circular motion like I normally do with a blending tool. And because this blending tool has the bristles, you can't damage your sponge because it has no sponge, right? That makes total sense, doesn't it? And even though I don't damage my sponges a lot with ink blending on stencils, this is actually a safer way to go. Especially when you are a bit heavy-handed, then this blending tool can be a great solution for you. I just fill up the complete background. I'm not worrying about color difference or blending or any fussy thing like that. I'm just adding some color, and I added more in the middle, as you can see, and a little bit less along the edges. But you can fill it in one complete color or all dark or all light, just whatever you prefer. And then I come in with my second stencil. I'm going to lay out the panel on top of the page. So the pattern is going from the inside out and it fits nicely on my previous stencil. And then I come in with my second color and I'm going to apply that over the complete stencil. So I pick up quite a bit of color and I add that in a circular motion, just like I did for the first layer. And this is a technique I learned from Ardit in one of our first collabs together. And I will link to that video in the description box below. So when I've added all my color, I'm going to pick up the stencils and take the first one away. And then I'm going to add the second one back in place. And now I'm going to take that second color ink and apply that again. And this is an important thing to remember. I'm only going to fill part of this stencil. I'm just applying it in a few places, because if you just fill the complete stencil, then that second step would not have been quite necessary because, well, you fill it the complete stencil anyway, so then the layering is, well, a lot of fuss for nothing because you're filling the complete stencil now. So we're not going to do that. I'm only filling parts of the stencil with the second color that I used. You can also go for a different color if you want to. That's also a great option. And I do that with quite a lot of ink, so it will be visible very well. And because there are parts that we didn't touch, you can see the color through the stencil now. And this will give you two things: a pattern on top of a pattern and a part of that pattern in between the previous pattern. So it looks like a lot of layers and it creates an amazing amount of depth without much effort. So I really like this look. I think it's pretty cool. I'm adding some ink around the edges to get rid of that white, so it has a bit more of a finished look to me. And then I decided to add the first stencil back in place to add some more of that first color ink, so it will be a bit of a deeper color and to make that first pattern pop a bit more. And because I'm adding the first stencil in place, I can add the ink on the complete piece. And the pattern of the first stencil was filled anyways, so the design won't change by adding a bit more ink with that first stencil. It's always cool to try a new to you technique, and it's also great fun to see if you can take that a bit further. So let's kick it up a notch again, and no worries, it's not going to be hard at all. We are just building on the previous technique. So I have a piece of acetate and I'm going to wiggle cut it. This is a fun technique I like to use for fussy cutting as well. Just wiggle with the acetate and make a fun wavy deckled line. I also have the outside edges of the acetate, so the parts that I cut off. I marked them with a piece of tape so they're easier to find back, and I also color coded them so it's easier to see which parts belong together. And I will need that for the last step. Now I add my acetate in place with the tape side down, and I add some tape to the back so the acetate stays in place. Then I add my stencil and I add a piece of tape at the top as well as at the bottom of the stencil. because it's the same size as my page. And then I add it on my makeup station with the big magnets on the acetate part. And then I'm going to apply my first color. I'm not worrying about perfect blending or darker areas, lighter areas. That's all fine. By the way, these are stencils designed by my friend Karen, and it's so incredibly cool if you know the designer that created the art supplies that you're working with. It's really cool. She made a gorgeous set of wonderful designs again, and I'm going to link to them in the description box so you can check them out if you want to. And now I'm going to add my second stencil, and I'm going to add some more colors. So I'm repeating the steps that I did for my first page. And because you have that acetate in place, you only have to fill part of that stencil. You can leave that middle part open. You don't have to add ink to the middle part, so that will save you some time. And now it's time to take off my stencils. Then I peeled off the tape for the second one so I could take away the second stencil. In between, I cleaned the second stencil. Make sure to remember what side of the stencil was up so you can add it back in place easily. And now I come in with a small blender brush. And these are Dauber size, so they are really great to color in smaller parts of the stencil. So I just color the hearts that are outside the acetate. And I color some parts on the outside edge as well. And this pink color will certainly pop from the page. And because it's distress oxide ink, it's opaque, so you can layer the colors on top of each other. And I find that these blender brushes work really great. It makes ink blending even more accessible, especially if you're not a really great ink blender. Then these brushes will certainly help to improve your skills and make you look really good, like you're an ink blender pro. And then the big reveal, taking off my stencil, and then I take off the acetate. And look, there you have a torn stencil. Then I check with my middle part acetate where the other parts need to be. And just by adding a bit of color in this way, you will create some more depth. And you also add a bit of interest to that white strip in the middle. And it also gives it a bit more of that finished look that I like so much. Are you ready to triple layer your stencils? Have lots of fun. The video I mentioned is right here if you'd like to check that out. And as always, make sure to keep on crafting.